care and that her constituents are grateful.
They say, thank you. Thank you for the fact that I can get insurance. Thank you for the fact that I can get it even if I have a heart condition.
Even if the Senate does pass the bill, it's not likely to become law because President Obama plans to veto it. Linda Kenyon, Capitol Hill.
Indiana Governor Mike Pence is meeting with a Roman Catholic Archbishop of Indianapolis one day after the Archdiocese said it has the means to resettle a Syrian refugee family bound for the state. Republican governor blocks state agencies from distributing federal money for Syrian refugees. More at townhall.com.
This is Larry Elder with an Elder Minute on the tale of two Chicago responses. Right after this.
Listen to the Larry Elder Radio Show. Just dial #250 and when prompted, say CRN Talk. The CRN app will be text message to your phone. Call #250 and say CRN Talk.
Chicago cop in October 2014 kills a black teenager. Videotape is released. A year later, protesters march. But 4 weeks ago, three Chicago gang members lured a 9-year-old from a park into an alley, then executed him, allegedly as an act of revenge against the boy's father for his ties to a rival gang. After his brother and mother were shot, reported the Tribune, three gang members had driven around on a daily basis looking for revenge. One vowed to kill grandmas, mamas, kids, and all. If anybody marched on the Magnificent Mile to protest yet another Chicago killing, this time the cold-blooded murder of a 9-year-old named Tayshaun Lee, the media failed to notice. I'm Larry Elder, and this has been an Elder Minute.
You know, they say in life, we should savor and slow down and enjoy things. That's what our hosts, Steve Andrews and Sally James, do on Slow Living Radio. They do everything slowly, and they do it for you Saturday and Sunday at 2 p.m., Tuesdays at 11 p.m., and Monday nights at 7 p.m. It's Slow Living Radio, the best in food, the best in entertainment, the best in drinks, including great wine. All with Sally James and Steve Andrews. Slow Living Radio on CRN. Welcome, welcome, welcome to PM Show, CRN Digital Talk Radio, nationwide, coast to coast, your sports beacon, the stories that you don't hear anywhere else. That's what we talk about here. It's the PM Show on sports each and every weekend. I'm Michael Horn, the star of our show. The man is on television these days, starring in the series Agent X. He's also the sports genius, the one and only legend of football, and a former baseball player, too, the one and only Fred Dreyer.
Thanks so very much, Mike Horn. Great to be with you again, side by side here at the mic. CRN Talk, and forgive me for a moment. I'm unwrapping this. Somebody sent me something in the mail, and I have no idea what it is. What is it? It's a. Oh yeah. Okay. Oh, okay. It's some sort of a book. That's very nice. Yes. Okay. Let's see.
Mail.
No. But
you got the mail open. What is that?
It's I don't know what it is. People send stuff, you know, and I don't know really what it is.
And nice, we got a little nice piece of mail there that came into us. I like it. It's good, and it looks like a book of some kind that you have there.
Yeah.
What is it?
This is a book on gambling.
Oh.
See?
You know, you and I don't want to talk about gambling here, but we usually pick the games. We did pretty well last week. I think we got like 9 correct. Which is probably a pretty good week for us.
Yeah, it was okay.
It was okay.
But
some teams are not performing, Fred.
Well,
with the Packers.
Well, there's the other thing. We're 11 games into a 16-game schedule, and you've got a lot of teams who are dogging it, and,
I
smell fix.
What?
I smell fix.
What do you mean by that?
I mean teams just not performing, and they're not it's too late in the season to be this erratic.
I agree with you. Things should be settled down by now, right?
You know, I used to tell people, speaking of gambling, if you're going to gamble, then I think the best thing that you could possibly do on football is wait until you're at 6 games into the season. So everything kind of settles down.
You get
down,
the lay of the land. You've talked about that.
And you kind of see what's going on and then lay it out.
Yeah.
You know?
I'm with you.
So, but this year it's been very difficult. Who would have imagined? I don't think I even mentioned it to you in your office that San Diego would fly all the way to Jacksonville and play one of their better games of the years and beat Jacksonville, who had been kind of waking up and coming around a little bit, you know. And it was another sour note. And, of course, Green Bay is terrible.
What's wrong with them?
They're terrible.
Yeah, what was happening?
You know, poor Bart Starr, you know. Seabart?
Yeah, well, he didn't look good.
He didn't look good. God bless him. You
yeah.
know? Good man.
Yeah, he is a good man.
Yeah, I knocked him on the ground a couple of times.
But I'm looking at Rodgers right now. What's going on with him? What's happening to the team?
They don't have Jordy Nelson, and they've got people who aren't getting open. And you know what? You saw the Detroit Lion game, what they did to him in Green Bay.
That's it.
They went man coverage. They just pressed him at the line of scrimmage, and no one could get free. And by that time, they had pressure on him.
Jordy Nelson coming back, not coming back?
Not this year,
not this year.
No.
You know who they're going to replace him with? Ozzie Nelson, from what I heard. Jordy's... late great great uncle.
It could be. It could be.
Ozzie-ian.
It could be. You might be right there. You might have some insight.
I doubt it. There's a lot of Nelson family members. I don't know if they're still with us. There was
a full Nelson and a half Nelson. I think those were.
That's very nice. Got to do the half Nelson is very good. Okay, yeah. Fred Dreyer is here. He is starring in a new series, Agent X. I discovered it on TNT. I'm telling you, the first episode I thought was weak. Everything from that point on has been growing. We'll talk about that a little bit. It's a good show. It's on TNT, Sharon Stone. I have not seen you in it yet. I'm in about three episodes
in. I was on last night.
Okay, I taped it then. I mean, Sunday night.
Yeah, Sunday night.
I got it on tape. It's good.
Get better than Black Friday deals at Lumber Liquidators Yellow and Black Friday Flooring Sale. Every floor in stock is on sale, including all pre-finished hardwood on sale from an unheard of 89 cents. All wood look tile on sale from 79 cents. All laminate and vinyl flooring on sale from an unbeatable 39 cents. Plus, save on bamboo, tools, installation, and more deals in your local store. And pay no interest till 2018. Who said Black Friday was the only day to save? Get deals all week at the Yellow and Black Friday Flooring Sale. Going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Hi, I'm Jay Farner, president of Quicken Loans. Call Quicken Loans now to see if you qualify for the government's Home Affordable Refinance Program, or HARP. And for 6 years in a row now, J.D. Power has ranked Quicken Loans highest in the nation in customer satisfaction. And for the second year in a row, they've also ranked us highest in mortgage servicing. Call 800-QUICKEN or visit quickenloans.com.
Visit jdpower.com for award information. Call for cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender, licensed in all 50 states, NMLSconsumeraccess.org, number 3030.
Welcome back here to the PM Show, Weekend Edition on CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Michael Horn, the star of our show, the Sultan of Safeties, two safeties in one game, the All-Pro defensive end, great playing career, signed by the New York Giants, he was with the New England Patriots for a while. That's a story on its own. And, of course, the great career with the Los Angeles Rams, and now the legendary actor from Hunter all the way up to the new series, Agent X. I'm talking about Fred Dreyer. So, Fred.
Thank you so much.
I go to my DVR, and I look, and I go, oh, my gosh, there's Agent X. So I look at the first episode, and I think at first, well, this might be kind of weak. It's Sharon Stone as the vice president. She discovers this underground, like, place where the vice president is. Everybody always wonders, the vice president, what are they in charge of? And the answer is nothing. In this case, they are in charge of an agent that kind of balances things out. It's kind of like
a James Bond.
A James Bond type thing. And the guy that plays that action role is pretty good. And so you see the first episode, all right, and by the time you look at the second and third episode, you're hooked, and you all of a sudden you forget about the underground altar, and you realize that there's a team building here, and there's good-looking women in the episodes. And I'm waiting for you to come on. You're saying that this last Sunday was your first episode,
that's
correct?
Right, that's right.
And what is the character? Who do you play, like a CIA agent? Is that correct?
Yeah, I'm Mike. I play Mike.
Mike?
Yeah.
What a great name for someone of power like yourself as a CIA agent. Mike. Mike or Michael?
That's not Michael. You don't have
it's Mike
secret
in the
series. Agents or anything.
Yeah,
Michael.
No, and Michael would be Mike.
So Mike.
This is good. I can't wait. It's like episode 6 you're in then, is correct?
I don't know.
Five or six. Maybe five.
It might be, but I'm in the last episode. The next one I'm is the last one.
Okay, so this is
the 12th one.
This is good, and I hope they renew it because it looks good.
Yeah,
it looks good.
I'm ex-CIA guy, and I'm...
I'm called upon.
I'm in hiding because of all the things I've done. I've been very naughty in the past, so a lot of people want to shoot me, and get rid of me. So I'm with my dog in my truck up in the hills, and then the star of the show comes in and says, I need to know some information that only you know. And so the scene is about me, as we're shooting guns at targets up there, we're talking about the things that he doesn't know, which now, after he hears them from me,
he knows.
Now knows, and it helps him solve the case.
This is great. I love this. So you're going to be like a guy there that's in a van down by the river with your dog.
Yes. Yes, that's exactly right.
Now, I'll be watching that. That's going to be one that's go to your DVR, go to your On Demand. You can get all the episodes. It's great. And what's nice about the TNT On Demand episodes, they only show like a minute worth of commercials on the break, and you just buzz through it in 47 minutes, you get the whole episode. I'm going to have a viewing party at my house
for your episode. You can binge it. Bring a six-pack.
I'll get some port for you.
Exactly.
Cigar?
Then we can just binge. Well, why not? But I've got to smoke a cigar in the house.
No, not going to happen.
Well, then
you can be outside and we'll throw blankets at you. Now, let's get into some sports news here this week. Okay, so here.
Yeah, what happened?
Anderson.
Dave Roberts
from the Dodgers. I like this guy. He brought the championship, the pennant, the World Series to the New England area of Boston with the Red Sox.
He was the straw that stirred the drink.
Stole the base. He was just crafty. He created this whole mental thing.
He ignited the powder keg.
He changed the whole movement of the game. And I'm telling you, I love him. He might be a good manager. And they had this big press conference for him this week.
You know how easy it is to be a manager.
How easy?
Seriously. If the organization gives you the players,
yes,
and you know that there should be 9 players, not 10 on the field.
He's aware of that. I'm sure Dave's got that. 9 players.
Yeah, and you can go around to the locker room and you can kind of manage people.
But they put those shifts on now, where even if you got the 9 players, they move them all to the right field.
That. Anybody can do that. They got a bank of people. You got a bench coach. You've got a third base coach. You got people that you respect, a pitching coach, you know, and an outfield coach, and a first base coach.
So it's a lot of what do you think?
People.
You say, what do you think?
No, it is. It's like you say, hey, you know, that's what a bench coach does. He helps the manager organize his thoughts so he can act. You know, the whole thing, the whole gag was about what makes a good manager is how do they handle a pitching staff. In other words, how does a manager run a game?
Correct.
How do you run a game? And the criticism on Mattingly was I think justified. Maybe he got better as time went on, but that's why I said I thought that the best choice for the Dodgers at this point in time was Bud Black. You know,
if you're going to turn a
multi-billion-dollar company over to somebody, yeah. you throw it to a guy who's managed in the league, managed in your division.
He was a pitcher.
And was with Mike Socia, so he has good breeding.
He would have been a good choice.
And he would have been a good choice to be able to lead people and to get them organized.
Plus, a name like Bud is good for baseball. Say, Bud. What do you think? That's a good name to have.
Yeah, so my point is that he would have people. Dave Roberts did this job for Bud Black in San Diego.
Yes, he was Bud Black's bench coach.
So he was an acting manager, and they were always conferring. So the choice doesn't surprise me that it's Dave Roberts. It's just that of the people that they could have hired at this point in time, what is it that turned the light on for the Dodgers was the fact that the guy had enthusiasm and they perceived that he would be a good guy in the clubhouse and be able to handle guys like Puig, Bad Brain Puig, and Bad Brain Baez.
We'll get into Puig.
And all of these guys. And so that's great. It's their prerogative to choose who they want to choose.
Okay, but they had a press conference, and I missed it, but you saw
it. I saw the whole thing.
And I'm just wondering, did Dave Roberts kind of rise to the fore with their hard-hitting questions, saying, hey, your team can't win a big one. Puig has been in boxing matches, fights in restaurants and everything. What are you going to do? Did they have
baseball,
those questions like
baseball
that?
Baseball writers never ask any questions.
That's terrible. I would have asked all those questions.
Well, what'd they ask? They asked, what's it like being the first minority coach?
Oh, come on. They didn't start with that.
Yeah, they did. They asked that question, then I turned it off, and then I came back to it about 20 minutes later, and they were still talking about mundane stuff.
Really?
You know, I remember when I was playing for UCLA, I'd listen to Dodger games and Vince Scully. There's stuff like that, reminiscing stuff. Nice stuff, that didn't mean anything. And I'm thinking to myself, here's what I'm saying, if I had just been hired.
Hired as a manager of the Dodgers,
I said, look,
what would you say?
It's a great organization. We all know that. I don't want to discard the opportunity to say what a wonderful organization is and how wonderful and how proud I am to accept the job. It's great to be here. Great to wear this number, blah, blah, blah. I'm an L.A. kid. I went to school here at UCLA. And all of these things. But here's what I know to be true. After playing in the league a long time, just because you play in the major leagues and make a lot of money doesn't mean you know anything about the game.
That's a good comment.
You can't tell me because you make $8 million and play in right field that you happen to understand the fundamentals of the game.
That's when Yasiel Puig says, he tired about me?
Yeah. So the idea is, I'm going to teach these guys. By the way, I'm going to hold infield before every game. That's what I'm going to do.
Really? You would say that?
That's what I would say. And then I would say, and we're going to be running a lot, and we're going to be stretching. And anybody who shows up with bad legs is going to be fined by me. I'm going to get some of that money back from them. And I don't want people showing up here insulting the fans, the organization, the teammates, and me.
Good answer. Is that what he said?
No.
That's what you would say.
That's what I would say. And I would say, I'm an aggressive guy. That's why I was hired. We're going to find out who wants to play baseball. I don't care how much money you make. You're going to play baseball or you're not going to play baseball.
I agree with you there. How would you answer the question if they said, what it's like being the first black manager on the Dodgers that you were hired?
And I'd say, it's wonderful. I've been black as far as I can remember. Yeah,
no, you're not black. So you'd have to say, wait a second.
No, I'm not black.
Right, that's what you have to say.
Oh, okay, I'm not black.
That's good.
Then I have to apologize to Magic Johnson.
Straight ahead, we continue. I want to find out if they got him a special number on his jersey. Straight ahead.
You're experiencing pain, back pain, shoulder, elbow, or hand pain from a sports injury. If so, schedule a visit with Dr. Michael Sheps, the leading expert in laser therapy for pain management. Call 310-873-4422 or go to drsheps.com. Experience Epic T, the breakthrough laser therapy system that Dr. Sheps developed to make you pain-free in less time. Laser therapy is a non-invasive, safe, and effective in-office procedure that penetrates deep into your skin without damaging the tissue. It perfectly targets areas of pain to promote fast, natural healing. Relax your muscles, ease muscle spasms, joint stiffness, and arthritis pain while increasing blood circulation. For over 25 years, Dr. Sheps has helped Olympic athletes and sports enthusiasts alike get back in the game. Schedule your visit with Dr. Sheps at his Brentwood office in California. Call 310-873-4422 or visit drsheps.com. That's drsheps.com, 310-873-4422.
Let me take just a moment or two, if I may, and talk about a great place to eat. That's right, for you folks anywhere in the eastern San Fernando Valley, drop into Bob's Big Boys. That's right, in Sun Valley at 8274 Sunland Boulevard. Now, everybody remembers the name Bob's. They're getting bigger and bigger every day. And little old Bob carrying the hamburger in his checkered overalls is the same Bob that you remember from back through the years. And, of course, if you want to go in for a great lunch, remember their classic burger, the original double-deck hamburger combination. Delicious 100% pure ground beef in two patties with American cheese, lettuce, and our famous Big Boy special sauce. The name is Bob, and I think when you go in, you'll say, by golly, I'm sure glad that I found this restaurant because it's good for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. They've got all kinds of things, and all you have to do is remember. Bob's Big Boy in Sun Valley at 8274 Sunland Boulevard. It's a great place to eat.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names.
Really?
They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
If you're struggling to find reliable senior living information for your mom or dad, then call or go online to get the free help you need during this turbulent time. Call now, 800-471-5173, 800-471-5173.
We'll be right back.
p.m. show nationwide, coast to coast, from CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Michael Horn, the star of our show, the one and only Fred Dreyer.
Thanks so much. Thanks for being here. Great. I honestly hope everybody had a great Thanksgiving.
Oh, yeah, we did. Everybody but Tomas.
Tomas
pressing all the buttons in there. Looks like he's kind of like piloting a spaceship or something. He's kind of leaned back and in sort of a daze.
Yeah, what's wrong with
you? Are you okay, Tomas? Jesus. Your microphone's on. You can say yes.
Yeah, did you?
Are you okay? Chances are?
Yes, I'm okay.
Okay, good.
Sounds good.
Yeah, he sounds all right.
Yeah,
it's good. All right, welcome back to the show.
Sounds sober.
So the Dodgers, they have this new manager, Dave Roberts, and he was introduced Tuesday at a big press conference as the manager.
Yep.
And they asked him if he was a people person, and they asked him about Yasiel Puig, who is this troublesome outfielder the Dodgers have, who everybody says is really talented, but the kid has not shown that talent because he's too busy drinking and carousing.
He's got a bad brain.
Recently he was beating up security staff at a nightclub after he argued with his sister and slapped a woman. This has got to tell you, the guy's got like of no moral character whatsoever. Anyway, they say they asked him whether he'd be able to ask Dave if he could forge a good relationship with this guy. They call Puig a five-tool guy.
Yeah.
What are the five tools? It's running, it's be able to steal a base
hammer,
hit.
Hammer, saw, nail, drill.
That's it. Being able to hit with power and all that stuff and become a pitcher. I don't know if we could do the pitching. But anyway, here's what Dave Roberts said. He said, Yasiel is ultra-talented, a special player, someone who is feared from the other side. This is a great opportunity for me to embrace him. I'm excited about it. And this is what he said. But he's not feared. I don't think Puig is feared. I think they know how to pitch him and get him out.
They pitch him
outside and he reaches for it and strikes out.
They laugh at him.
He doesn't know. No one sat him down and said, hey, you're going to have to discipline yourself at the plate.
See, that's why I say if I'm a manager, I aim everything at the lowest common denominator, and that's Yasiel Puig. But go ahead, finish your...
Well, that's what he said. He said the Andrew Friedman was there, and he is the boss there of the Dodgers. He's the president. Isn't he Friedman the president or the general manager?
He pointed to Dave
Roberts, and he said he has an infectious personality, not just this baseball acumen.
He has an infection.
Oh, is that what it was?
Yeah.
It was. I'm sorry. I thought it was an infectious
person. No, read it again.
Okay, sorry. So the team president of baseball operations then talked about Dave's positive energy that he radiates.
Tommy would radiate gas after all that prostate.
Is that what it was? Was it prostate problem?
Prostate.
Okay, yeah, so that's it. His ability to connect with others, it says he seems like the kind of person who would get the most from his players. Now, Don Mattingly was also considered a people person when he was with the Dodgers, but he was never able to get through to Puig, ever.
Well, nobody is.
Because Puig's got a bad brain, as you said.
He's got a bad brain. What are you going to
do? So when Mattingly was there, Puig's work habits were widely questioned. Some teammates felt he was disrespectful toward them. His attention strayed in the meetings, also in the games. His behavior was tolerated because he was hitting. But when he wasn't hitting, he played his first All-Star game. And after that All-Star game, when he bombed out on the home run derby, the guy became nothing.
Well, he showed up at the All-Star game with a carved hairdo.
He did. Didn't he have like a...
Yeah, he had a ship. It was a ship, I think, carved in the side of his head.
He did. He actually... he's not kidding you.
He is.
Fred Dresden, he actually had like something carved in...
No, it was... It had,
like they mowed your lawn and put in USC.
Pirate ship. It was a pirate ship.
Was it a pirate ship or something in there?
The pirates all over the back of his head.
Anyway, so here's one... This is a little hubbub on the Dodgers because Scott Van Slyke on the Dodgers, his father, Andy Van Slyke, great Cardinal player, implied in a recent radio interview, he said Clayton Kershaw, the Dodgers star pitcher, told the front office he thought Puig should be traded.
What?
And Puig should be traded. And Kershaw has not commented on this, but Andrew Friedman said, quoting now, I think Yasiel Puig can be a significant part of future success for Los Angeles.
Well, he also said that didn't happen.
And Clayton also said it didn't happen. You're right. Andrew Friedman said
Friedman
that.
Friedman said no. Clayton did not say that.
Yeah, but Clayton hasn't said anything yet, according
to
this article here.
He's trying to cover for...
So anyway,
it's like he's trying to send Clayton a message saying, I'm covering for you by saying for you that you didn't say that. So when they ask him, he's right, I didn't say that.
So the commissioner's office is investigating Puig because of this domestic violence policy. As you said, he hit his sister, had a big altercation at a Florida nightclub, a fight with a bouncer at a Miami bar.
I don't have a sister. I wish I did have a sister.
I don't have a sister either.
You don't.
No, I don't. I have a brother. That's my cousin. No,
oh, that's
but my cousin's father is my dad's real brother, and my cousin's mom is my mom's real sister. So it's kind of like...
So you have a dog.
Yes, and I got a dog also.
Right.
But anyway, you were saying you don't have a sister,
I don't have a sister. I wish I did have a sister. Okay. I would love to have a sister.
That's all
I
you
would like
to, say?
To call her up and talk to her at moments when I'm feeling blue. She would be more sensitive than my brother would be.
Well, the Dodgers are counting on Puig because they might lose Howie Kendrick in the free agent market. I just think the Dodgers are in trouble. That's what I would say. What number is we were going to talk about his uniform. You
30.
You have a uniform story for us?
30. I got a uniform story, a story that has something to do with Magic Johnson.
That's Maury Wills' old number.
And he gave permission.
Isn't that retired?
He gave permission.
Oh, he did? That's great.
Yes, of course.
Now, that's a class thing the Dodgers did.
Oh, Maury's great.
I love Maury. We got to get him on the show. Maury just won't hold back. He'll tell you what he thinks.
Yeah, okay.
You order a glass of your favorite Cabernet. Fresh asparagus. Hollandaise on the side. A filet, medium rare. You unfurl your napkin with a flair. Close your eyes and prepare to listen. Ah, there it is. The sweet music you long to hear. The sizzle. The sizzle of a Ruth's Chris steak.
The most magnificent corn-fed prime beef. Broiled to perfection at 1,800 degrees. Some call it a sizzle. We call it an anthem.
As the waiter approaches, you think, is this one mine or that one?
Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. Like Ruth always said, life's too short to eat anywhere else.
Make a reservation online at RuthsChris.com or by calling 800-544-0808.
Are you nearing eligibility for Medicare benefits? Then you know now is an important time in your life. Medicare benefits can be a complicated puzzle. You don't want to overpay for your Medicare coverage or get the wrong plan. Let Health Markets Insurance Agency help you. With one free phone call, a licensed insurance agent will help you select a Medicare plan that's right for you and your budget. If you're becoming eligible for Medicare, call today and learn how to get the most out of your benefits.
800-793-1960. 800-793-1960.
Health Markets Insurance Agency is the DBA or assumed name of InSphere Insurance Solutions, Inc., which is an authorized insurance agency in all 50 states and the District of Columbia. Not all agents are licensed to sell all products. Service and product availability varies by state.
Call 800-793-1960. 800-793-1960. 800-793-1960. 800-793-1960.
CRN travelers, relax at the beautiful Fountain Grove Inn and Conference Center in Santa Rosa, California. Come to quality and come to luxury. Experience the newly renovated guest rooms. They're generously sized and they're decorated in the Tuscan tradition. They have great, incredible pillow top mattresses, luxurious linens, and down-fill comforters. The Fountain Grove Inn also offers complimentary Wi-Fi and internet access. There's warm cookies and coffee every evening in the hotel lobby, and you can visit the newly remodeled Equus Restaurant and Equus Lounge with its new wine bar. It's the ideal place to relax and enjoy a glass of wine and watch our What's Cooking On Wine show on CRN with host Larry Van Alst on Wednesdays. It's the Fountain Grove Inn, Hotel, and Conference Center, located in the heart of Sonoma wine country. It's easily located in Santa Rosa, off the 101 Fountain Grove Parkway exit. Call 707-578-6101. That's 707-578-6101, or visit fountaingroveinn.com.
You hear that, kid? That's the hum of a well-run facility. You know what I hate hearing? Silence. Silence on a production line means downtime. Downtime means wasted time. Wasted time means wasted money. Silence isn't golden, kid. It's deadly. That's why I love Grainger. With a wide variety of the latest products, Grainger gets us what we need when we need it to help keep this place up and running and humming away. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgrainger.com or stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
AJ here from the Tee It Up Radio Network. Each week we cover the world of golf for you. Celebrating 18 years, Tee It Up continues to bring you fresh inside the ropes reporting and one-on-ones with Hollywood's most passionate golfers. So stay in the know with the Tee It Up show, Sunday morning, 6 to 8 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, live right here on CRN, Digital Talk Radio.
Catch the gang from Tee It Up on CRN 1, Sunday, 6 to 8 a.m. Pacific Time, 9 to 11 a.m. Eastern Time, right here on CRN, Digital Talk Radio.
Welcome back here to the PM Show, weekend edition on sports from CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Michael Horn, the star of our show. One and only Mr. Fred Dreyer, star agent, ex-sports legend. And so you watched this Dave Roberts press conference last Tuesday.
Yes, I did.
And he was announced as the new manager of the Los Angeles Dodgers.
Yeah. Good for him.
And so he's wearing number 30. That's Maury Wills' old jersey for the Dodgers, the base-stealing champion from 1962. Yes. And so 104 bases that year set a record.
Right.
So let me ask you this.
Yep.
What did they do for the uniform thing? They bring it out, and you said they asked Maury Wills' permission. I like that.
Yes. There's a couple of things. I know in football that they hold players' uniforms who are great, prolific players. They hold them back. And they don't issue them. They don't retire them. They just don't put them into circulation for a while.
Right.
Okay.
Because they were so legendary.
Yeah, they just don't.
Number 60, Garvey, 30, Maury Wills.
You're not going to have Maury. You're not going to have a Merlin Olsen, 74.
That's right. Number 53, Don Drysdale.
On a guy who's covering punts. You know, you're just not going to. You're not going to let that happen.
Yeah.
If you have any brains at all.
You're going to wait a while.
Yeah, you're going to wait for a while. And so, and then you're going to retire their number, which they did. And so, you know, same with Jack Youngblood's number, 85. They still haven't given that out. They're not going to give
it out. How about your number?
89. They gave it out. They gave my number out
to who?
So fast.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, they tried to get rid of me. That's what they did. They
fired me.
So they
gave your number out quickly.
Yeah. The day I was told by Todd Hewitt, you know, Don Hewitt's son, equipment manager, he said, we were told by Don Klosterman to give your jersey out the day you left.
Wow.
And they gave it to some guy who was covering punts.
Wow.
Yeah. So that's
is there an 89 on the Rams now?
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. But anyway, that's how it was. But here's what happens. Maury Wills is 30, is not retired by the Dodgers because he's not in the Hall of Fame.
Right.
Now, if you are, it's going to be retired.
Right.
Maury should be in the Hall of Fame.
Yes, he should be.
Okay. He's not. So to my way of thinking, that number, 30, has been given to too many players over the years. It's become a common issue, they call it. You know, it's been issued to too many players over too many years, and it's become abused.
Yes,
that's my view. That's my view.
I agree with you.
So they gave it to Schebler this last year, Scott Schebler.
Yeah,
and he had 30, and so
30 strikeouts.
So exactly.
Yeah,
in 30 minutes.
Yes.
So Scott Schebler has 30, number 30. And so when Dave Roberts got the job, he asked if he could have his old Dodger number,
which
that
was
he
30
wore,
also
that he wore, and asked Maury Wills in 2002 when he was here if he could wear it.
Right.
He asked permission. Maury said, "Yeah, go ahead." So they issued him the number for the two years that he was here before he went to Boston. Okay. So that number was his. So now he wanted it back. So he said, well, Schebler's got it. So we called Schebler, and Schebler said, oh, I understand completely. You can have it back. So they made the jersey available for the press conference.
Oh, so they were going to present Dave Roberts with the number 30 jersey.
So
he could try it on and everything. He wasn't wearing it when he was there. They're going to bring it to him, right?
Yeah. So the idea was, you could see it, that they said, you know, we have Dave Roberts here, and before we get started here, let's Magic
Magic Johnson, one of the owners of the Dodgers, yeah. I'm just setting up the stage for you. I want to make sure they know.
All right. So I think people know who Magic Johnson is.
Well, it could have been Magic Ed who fixes television.
So I said Magic Johnson.
Yeah, okay, Magic Johnson. Yeah.
Is that the floor shine
one of the owners of the Dodgers. The
Magic floor shine?
So Magic Johnson is bringing this jersey out.
So it says, Magic, you want to bring the jersey out.
Yes.
So Magic knows, this is my point, he knows the entire day what the proceedings was going to be. Magic, you're the big dummy that's now going to be in charge of the jersey.
Bring it out.
Bring it out when we say bring it out.
Right.
And come over here
and then
put it on the manager and let him button the top button and then stand there so people can applaud.
Exactly. There it is. Like,
welcome.
What a great moment.
Here's your cap.
That's
here's
it.
Your cap.
Yes.
Round the
I
bill off.
Yeah, yeah.
Sit the hat on your head
sure
and sit down and start the conference.
Perfectly planned and executed. Perfect.
He knows that's going to happen.
Magic knows that.
So here's what happens.
Magic Johnson. Yeah.
So Magic want to bring the jersey out? Okay. So he comes around, shows up.
He brings the jersey.
He brings
out,
the jersey
just
out,
like you said,
and he kind of it was kind of, you know, folded over his arm, and
right.
It was in a clump, kind of,
yes,
you know.
Clump.
So he opens up the shirt.
Put it on.
He unfolds the shirt. He unfolds the shirt and sees that it's buttoned.
Wait a minute. They had the things.
Don't stop me. Yes. Don't stop. Just don't stop.
Let's go ahead.
So the jersey's buttoned up.
Yeah.
And so now the momentum of him standing, presentation of the jersey.
Putting it on.
Here comes Magic, who's, you know, I don't know what he does over there. So
he's the owner.
He kind of like opens up the shirt and it's buttoned. And then he looks at it and there's a tag on
no,
it.
No, come on.
So he pulls it.
Had to pull a tag off?
Pulls the tag off.
Yes.
And then starts fumbling with the buttons. And now Dave Roberts is kind of awkwardly standing there. And he almost wants to reach over and help unbutton
right.
it.
Get the shirt off.
So Magic figures it out. He had to figure it out.
He did,
how to unbutton it.
Yes.
He unbuttons it. And then Farhan, you know, I don't know what he does.
Yeah, he's one
but
of the
he says, oh, there we go.
He built time.
No, he wanted to put some momentum back into this blown it. Moment. This is a blown
so
moment.
So it took a while for him to pump for into this
so,
jersey.
So, yes, he opens it up, and then he puts it on Dave, and Dave wraps it around, and you know, the other guy. What's the guy's name? Andrew? What does he do, by the way?
Andrew, he's like the president.
Yeah, okay. So he presides over this failed moment.
For the general manager.
And so he puts on the shirt, and he stands there, and he's very proud, you can see.
Yeah, of course.
God bless him. You know, he's happy as hell.
He's happy as hell.
And if he's happy, I'm going to be happy,
too. How long did this whole procedure take?
It seemed like a day and a half. It seemed like an eternity. But the moment, here's the moment. You know, you've been given an assignment.
To put the manager's
jersey. When we say go, you should say, okay, I got to have it unbuttoned so it goes smooth.
Yes.
I got the hat right here. I'm
going to
get it
off.
Take all the tags off of it and just let me get in and then get out.
Did Dave, when he pulled
that didn't happen.
Did Dave Roberts, when Magic Johnson pulled off the label there, did Dave look at it and go like, oh, this is authentic Major League
Baseball?
No, he didn't
touch it.
No,
he didn't touch it. But Magic was, he's 6'12". You know, this guy's huge. And so he's standing there hunched over this little article of clothing. Everyone's staring at him for a moment, and he's mumbling. I see it. The button. Yeah,
I want to see the label. I think it probably was from Target. And then Dave Roberts said, you got this at Target?
It was so rich, I couldn't take it.
Get better than Black Friday deals at Lumber Liquidators Yellow and Black Friday Flooring Sale. Every floor in stock is on sale, including all pre-finished hardwood on sale from an unheard of 89 cents. All wood look tile on sale from 79 cents. All laminate and vinyl flooring on sale from an unbeatable 39 cents. Plus, save on bamboo, tools, installation, and more deals in your local store. And pay no interest till 2018. Who said Black Friday was the only day to save? Get deals all week at the Yellow and Black Friday Flooring Sale. Going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Get your Plenty card at Exxon or Mobil and start earning points at lots of places.
So I get points for filling up at Exxon?
You sure do.
What about getting coffee at Mobil?
Points.
Streaming TV shows on Hulu?
Definitely.
Points on my AT&T wireless bill?
Yep.
Buying soap?
At Rite Aid.
Buying you a birthday present?
Points at Macy's.
Visiting your parents?
No. You get marriage points.
Oh.
Exxon and Mobil are the only fuel brands that are part of Plenty, the rewards program that lets you earn points at one place and use them at another. Join Plenty for free through a participating Exxon or Mobil station today. Terms and limitations apply. See Plenty.com/partners for details.
You're experiencing pain, back pain, shoulder, elbow, or hand pain, pain from a sports injury. If so, schedule a visit with Dr. Michael Sheps, the leading expert in laser therapy for pain management. Call 310-873-4422 or go to drsheps.com. Experience Epic T, the breakthrough laser therapy system that Dr. Sheps developed to make you pain-free in less time. Laser therapy is a non-invasive, safe, and effective in-office procedure that penetrates deep into your skin without damaging the tissue. It perfectly targets areas of pain to promote fast, natural healing. Relax your muscles, ease muscle spasms, joint stiffness, and arthritis pain while increasing blood circulation. For over 25 years, Dr. Sheps has helped Olympic athletes and sports enthusiasts alike get back in the game. Schedule your visit with Dr. Sheps at his Brentwood office in California. Call 310-873-4422 or visit drsheps.com. That's drsheps.com, 310-873-4422.
Welcome back here to the PM Show, weekend edition on CRN Digital Talk Radio. I'm Michael Horn, the true star of our show, the man you heard telling that great Dave Roberts story, the one and only Mr. Fred Dreyer.
Thank you so much.
Some baseball notes here. The Orioles have acquired Mark Trumbo. I always liked this guy, Mark Trumbo, from the Mariners. So I think that's going to help the...
Mark Trumbo.
Yeah, Trumbo was on the Angels. I always liked him there. And then he was on the Diamondbacks, and then he was on the Mariners, and the Mariners got catcher Steve Clevener.
Dalton Trumbo?
Yeah, just Mark Trumbo. And the Padres got Drew Pomeranz and Jose Torres from the Athletics. And here's the thing. They're saying now, you know, this the big money baseball pitcher was signed up with the Red Sox over there. Who was it? Price? David Price?
Yeah.
Was with Toronto. He's signed a big deal with the Red Sox. So they're saying now that Zach Greinke's got two choices. He's either going to go with the Giants or the Dodgers.
And who said that?
You said that last week.
But who said that, though?
You said he's not going to sign with the Dodgers. I hope the hell he does, or we're in trouble.
But remember what I told you? I told you.
Because he likes California. The wife
wants
to stay here. And so
he's a West Coast guy.
Or Dodgers.
He's going to re-sign with the Dodgers, which I don't believe he will.
Why not? Puig's still there.
Well, you know something? Exactly.
If they traded Puig, he might come back.
And here's the other thing. I think their Dodgers have re-signed Honeycutt.
Yeah, they have already. They did that right away.
So that's something in their favor.
That's something they make because he likes Honeycutt.
He does love it, and he should. He's the best there is.
Honeycutt is very good.
So I don't think that he's going to sign with the Giants. But I did say that's a great possibility because Giants have absolutely no pitching.
They need somebody to
they're all hurt.
Offset
all these
the
guys
Madison
are hurt.
Baumgartner is what they need. They got their 1-2 punch. Now, Kobe Bryant this week is another thing you've been talking about. He announced his retirement from... Yeah. As a surprise, I found this.
You found that a surprise?
$30 million he's making for the year, and he's going to retire at the end of this year.
Yeah.
And
but he's going to...
He read a poem. He had a poem that he wrote.
I've read it so many times.
Do you like it?
No.
We did a reading of it, if you'd like. Tomas, actually, we didn't have any romantic music in the
background.
Can he
sing it as Johnny Mathis?
He can sing Chances Are in the background, and I'll read this poem a little bit if you'd like to.
Let's see. What's the
Can you give
poem?
Us a little Chances Are? It's got to be a romantic kind of feel.
Where's the poem? Not yet. I'm not ready.
Okay,
not
second
ready
page. Second page in there.
I'm just not ready.
Kobe Bryant.
Okay, here it is.
Yeah. Starts, My Heart Can Take the Pounding.
My heart can take the pounding. Mm-hmm. My mind can handle the grind. But my body knows it's time to say goodbye.
That's the deal.
So
Tomas, don't leave. We need you right in there to sing some Chances Are. Do not get up and walk out. Please, if you will, and don't stop till we get through. We're going to go every other line, Fred and myself, with a dramatic read. Please, if you will. Ladies and gentlemen, here's the karaoke legend, Tomas, to sing the background, and I'll just control the level here. Thank you, Tomas. A little Chances Are, if you could.
Keep it down.
Please, I will. Here we go. Go ahead.
Chances are...
And that's okay.
Because I wear you,
every other line. And that's okay. You go, I'm ready to let you go.
I'm ready to let you go.
I want you to know now,
so we both can savor every moment we have left together.
The good and the bad.
We have given each other
all that we have.
And we both know, no matter what I do next,
I'll always be that kid
with the rolled up socks,
garbage can in the corner,
0.05 seconds on the clock,
ball in my hands,
5, 4, 3, 2. 1.
Love you always,
Kobe. All right, that's it.
There were no lyrics in there. It was just kind of a mumble, but thank you, Tomas. Ladies and gentlemen, the great karaoke legend, Tomas, giving us live background bumper music. That was a very inspiring poem that Kobe wrote.
Yeah, it was.
What's that thing with his ball in my hands?
I don't know. I don't want to get into it.
I don't want to get into that.
I don't want to psychoanalyze.
Thank you.
Okay, he's gone. Now, I remember what I said. Remember what I said to you a long time ago.
A long time ago.
A couple of years ago.
He's got to step aside for the Lakers to become a great team.
That's correct. And here's the deal.
Said it every week on the show.
Yeah, well, I'm going to say it again.
Man, one more time.
Well, look, he's the one that's still playing basketball. I've asked him to stop several years ago.
I know you did, and he didn't listen to you, but now he's gotten the message.
So now he got the message.
Fred Dreyer asked you to leave, and he's now retiring.
Yeah, please leave. Now, and here's my reason. Not because I have disrespect for him.
Are
you kidding me?
He's
a top 10
player
of all time. He's the best. I love him. He's great.
He's a great player.
Now, he's great. No, seriously.
His body is broken down, like he said in the poem.
But it's done now.
It's
okay.
Done.
But here's what should happen. Here's what should happen. The poem is self-serving. You know, it's his moment.
Yep.
And he's decided to say goodbye in this fashion,
yeah,
in
right.
this form.
That's
okay,
fine.
Great.
That's
now, here's what should happen.
What?
Kobe, you're sitting on the bench. That's what you're going to do.
Yeah.
You're going to play the first 5 minutes of the first quarter. You're going to play the first 5 minutes of the second half.
Yeah.
And maybe three or four.
I agree with
three
you.
Or 4 minutes, 5 minutes.
That's coach got to do that.
That's 15 minutes.
Yeah.
And dump every basketball player off of that bench
in the game
out onto the floor and force them to play together for the next 75 games.
Now, right.
Now, here's the reason why.
I like this.
Here's the reason why. You've got this year left to prove that the people you have on your team isn't, number one, serving Kobe Bryant. Number two is now has an opportunity to play a lot of minutes together
and get
to get good. Yep. Why? Here's why. Here's why. So at the end of this year, when Kobe's gone and you've got tons of money, more than any team in basketball will have,
right,
you'll be able now to realistically go out into the free agent market and say to people, did you see the way our guys played?
I'm with you.
Did you see we've got good players here.
Yeah.
And they'll say, you know, you got some good young players. Kobe's gone. Sign me up.
That's the reason
the other guys didn't show up. They didn't want to play with Kobe. I said that a long time ago. Come here and play with Kobe and help him get another ring. That they don't care about that. They want a ring. They're not going to sit here. We're going to help Kobe, who's 38.
I mean,
what do we need that for?
By the way, we've signed Kobe to work with you here on the show.
Yeah, well, he better come prepared.
Yeah, he'll be prepared.
And I've got some poems I'm going to read.
And Magic Johnson's going to be here with him and present him with a uniform buttoned.
You hope he
stay with
us. He can fiddle with the button.
Experience the romantic getaway you deserve at Maui's premier bed and breakfast, the Plantation Inn. With plantation-style architecture and decor combined with modern amenities such as dual rain showers and whirlpool hot tubs, guests relax in a tranquil oasis in the heart of Maui's historic Lahaina town. The inn is situated conveniently less than 2 blocks from Lahaina Harbor, as well as the famous French Street, known for its range of shops, restaurants, gallery walks, and museums. The Plantation Inn is home to Gerard's Restaurant, voted Open Table's top most romantic restaurants in North America. Chef Gerard's contemporary island French cuisine consistently earns some of the highest ratings in Hawaii. Come discover why Hawaii Magazine readers named the Plantation Inn number one best bed and breakfast in Hawaii. Visit theplantationinn.com or call us at 667-9225.
Hi, I'm Joan London, and if you're worried about your parent or a loved one living alone, like I was, and you want reliable senior care information, then call A Place for Mom, the nation's largest senior living referral service. You'll get free information on assisted living, Alzheimer's care, nursing homes, even important financial information.
They had obviously researched every place, not just given me names. Mm-hmm. They found me a place for what she could afford, and it was magnificent.
We're now very confident that she's safe, and they just helped every step of the way, and I can't thank them enough.
So if you're struggling to find reliable senior living information, call A Place for Mom. This is a free service, and you can trust them to help you.
If you're struggling to find reliable senior living information for your mom or dad, then call or go online to get the free help you need during this turbulent time. Call now, 800-471-5173, 800-471-5173.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. Attention men who've taken Androgel or any other testosterone therapy products. Androgel or other low-T products have been linked to heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, even death. Scientific studies indicate that the use of testosterone therapy products may double a man's risk of heart attack. If you or a loved one took Androgel or a testosterone therapy product and suffered from a heart attack, stroke, pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, or any other cardiac event, you might be entitled to financial compensation. You have rights, and you need to let us fight for your rights. And you pay no fees unless we win. So call the tort attorneys right now. 800-557-7921. 800-557-7921. That's 800-557-7921. Cases may be referred to participating law firms in your jurisdiction.
PM Show, Weekend Edition on Sports. I'm Michael Horn. star of our show, the man, two safeties in one game. We call him the Sultan of safeties, the all-pro defensive end. So many years with the great Rams, played with the Giants, had a breath of air at the New England Patriots. And, of course, the acting legend. Guy that did Hunter Land's End, just to name a couple there, Crisis last year, Agent X this year, recurring role. Talking about the one and only Mr. Fred Dreyer.
Thanks so very much. Great to be back with you folks. And let's see, we have, this is our last segment.
NFL has a, they're headed towards a vote January 12th to 13th in Houston. And ESPN's Shelley Smith there and Jake Trotter said that sources at this point say there's zero chance of a partnership between Chargers owner Dean Spanos and Rams owner Stan Kroenke. And the source close to the negotiations told Shelley Smith of ESPN, the Raiders still believe they have a chance to move to L.A. and that they have a better chance with the Chargers and the Rams if paired on the stadium deal. Fred Dreyer, you've been thinking that the Stan Kroenke's coming here. What do you think?
Here's my bullet. Here's my bullet. I'm going to fire right now.
Fire it off.
Stan Kroenke is moving to Los Angeles. He is not going to sit around and be gerrymandered by the likes of the Raiders and the Chargers. He's got property here. He has 50-plus years of his franchise being here. He wants to come back. It was a mistake for this franchise to be pulled out of here, and this league is guilty for allowing it to happen. And if I'm Stan Kroenke, I'm letting people know I've got property here. I bought it myself. I'm going to fund this building myself. And as soon as I move this franchise here, I will have gained another $1 billion+ in equity.
Smart.
And I'm doing it. And if you don't like it, you can sue me. And we know where that will go. That's what I'm doing if I'm him. And here's why I do it. It's going to smoke out the Oakland Raiders. And you remember, the league is going to fight like hell to keep three teams from moving. They do not want three teams here.
No, they don't.
That's right. So it seems as Kroenke, Inglewood is a pretty good venue, and they can move it faster because they don't have to go through the city ordinances.
Right, because Inglewood's not part of L.A. City.
It's not. And so,
it's a windfall.
So, all Kroenke has to do is come out and just simply say, this February, when they supposedly going to meet, you know, someplace and, you know, and have a vote, that he's going to say, I'm moving. I'm telling St. Louis right now, I'm moving. I'm telling the city of Inglewood, I'm moving. And I'm telling my bankers, I'm moving. I'm telling the people that are on my team that I'm moving. I'm going to do a deal with the Coliseum, and I'm going to play here the following year, probably 17.
Yes, of course, yeah.
17. I'm going to play 17 here, and then we're going to wait till my building is put up, and then I'm moving this franchise here. And if the league doesn't like it, they can sue me. And we all know where that'll go. I'm doing it, and it's for the betterment.
I'm liking your
thought. For the betterment of my franchise.
I think it's for the betterment of football.
Yes.
LA's been without a team for how many years now?
20.
Come on, it's ridiculous.
21 years.
Unbelievable. The NFL. 94. NFL used to be a great name. It's tarnished these days, whoever's running that organization.
Not for long. That's the new.
It's really going to be something new happening there, huh?
Not for long. NFL.
NFL?
Yeah.
Not for long. NFL. Not for long.
Yes, not for long.
I like it.
Yeah, of course. So I look at it this way, and then SC hires Todd Helton or Chip Helton, whatever his name is, Clay Helton. And that's
John.
Okay. That's okay. You know,
Elton John.
They're under the crunch. He's good enough. He'll rally the guys. But you know, what are you gonna do?
I thought NFL was some kind of a marketing tool for the subway chain. No footlongs left. Wasn't that what it was?
Originally, that's what it was created for.
All right, that's our show. We got to get out. If you missed anything, go to our website at crntalk.com. crntalk.com/PM show. Fred Dreyer, that you'll have it. Follow Fred on Twitter, Fred_Dreyer. On Facebook, The Real, facebook.com/TheRealFredDreyer. Fred Dreyer at crntalk.com. Final thoughts, Fred?
I'm going to go buy a Christmas tree this next weekend.
CRN Digital Talk Radio prides itself on being the station of every situation. And you can listen to us on nearly any platform and device. Download to your iPhone, Android, and BlackBerry episodes of What's Cookin'. And take